Greetings and welcome back.
I am pleased to see you once more, Hierarch.
And this is my Let's Play Legacy of the Void series.
Your announcement of Ire's reclamation.
As did I.
Instead everyone died.
Then the threat is greater than I realized.
We cannot let the same fate befall Shakuras.
It is too late for that. Amon Zerg poured through the warp gates of Tide of Flesh and Blade. They have already overrun Telemetros and are nearing the shrines of Lazul. This world is lost. With such an infestation, Shakuras must
be destroyed.
Got some
serious braids on.
Destroy Shakuras? I will not permit this.
Permit? Shakuras was my people's home long before we offered your sanctuary upon it.
Nice.
I will not let this world be a den for Amon's forces. Worlds may fall to ash. What matters is that we endure.
And these Dark Templar are pretty boss.
To lose Shakuras and Ire.
We are a vagabond people, Artemis. Our true home has
that didn't translate right. She meant to say something a little less hobo-like.
It is fitting that the daughter of Raja Gal decides the fate of the world she helped forge. Let us make preparations at once.
To blow up Shakuras.
Hierarch, I have powered up a new ship subsystem. You can review it in the solar core now.
Sorry, dude. Busy.
You never wavered in the belief that our two peoples could live in unity. It is something I admired in you.
But I stopped admiring it.
Say this. All this time, I believed you were reluctant to accept the unity I sought.
You and I had many a disagreement in the Twilight Council. For day by day, I saw my people losing what they were. I saw our precious old ways erode.
You wished to preserve them.
I am Nerazim, Dark Templar. I hold great pride in my people.
But you are also Protoss. That is the greater affiliation.
Mm. That is not what the Conclave believed when we were exiled long ago. Your kind had Ire. Our culture is all we ever had.
True. Well, let's just take a look at the missions here.
This was not an easy decision, but I would rather see Shakuras destroyed than overwhelmed by Amon Zerg. We have much to plan, Hierarch.
I feel like she texted me, even though she was standing right there with that. That was like a mental text. She's much quieter. Destroy the Zenith Stones within the first 10 minutes of the last stand. Hold out until 1.8 billion Zerg arrive on Shakuras in the last stand mission. Okay. Alright. Let's consider this. Destroy Zenith Stones first 10 minutes. Okay, that should be pretty fast. Zerg life science 50 million, and we want 1.8 billion. Well, there's no way to predict exactly what that means. Rohanna, speak with
all
me.
This time,
I thought I put her in stasis.
This wretched little world was within striking distance of our fleets.
Much has changed since your era.
Oh, she's a racist.
First you consort with those Terrans, and
those
now
orifices.
The fallen ones? It is heresy. You must know this.
The dark
now, someone get her a sheet with a pointy
allies.
Top.
There was a time when the Protoss were broken. Throughout the aeon of strife, we tore at each other with wanton abandon. Only one path was ever found to end the madness and unify our people. The Kala. The Dark Ones rejected its light. They denied their own race. How can you fight for them?
For one so sworn to preserve our history, Rohanna, how can you be so blind to its turn?
I see I have offended you, Hierarch. My apologies. Adapting to this period is difficult.
Interesting.
Cloaked warriors are now available for deployment.
I like cloaked warriors. Okay, Shadow Fury. Cooldown 15 seconds. Dark Templar jumps from target to target, dealing 35 damage each jump. Hits 5 times. What? And then they return to where they started? Whoa. Permacloaked.
Vengeance for ire.
What are these? Avenger automatically recalled to a dark shrine with full shield and life upon taking fatal damage. This effect cannot occur more than once every minute. Wow. Wow. I'm gonna have to...
Got to.
So, one's more deadly. Obviously, if you're a little better micro-managing your units, the Shadow Fury is going to dish out a lot more pain. The Avengers, however, are just, like, kind of easy mode with your, like, why be careful? You can just suicide them every minute, which is really short. And really brutal. So let's see how effective the Dark Templar ones are. Well, this is kind of a holdout mission, actually. Let's go with the Avengers this time. yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, let's go with the Avenger. The Dark Templar one, that seems like it would be good in a mixed unit combination where the recall ability, if you're just going to go really heavy into Dark Templar and have like an assault force of them, you can just afford to like throw it away occasionally. And I feel like in this particular scenario, it could actually be kind of beneficial to attack with a group of these Avenger things, because this seems like a holdout mission, to attack into the enemy, which is probably overwhelming, have them actually die, and then respawn at your base to defend it every now and then. So, this seems like a very efficient way to go about it. Oh, I forgot. We should pick the other ones. Let's go with these immortal. I think tough is going to be better. Yeah, we'll keep the blink stalkers. Shadow charge or whirlwind. If I go... Let's try whirlwind again. Okay, Solar Core. Talk to me, Carrick.
What have you discovered about the Keystone, Faye Smith?
Only that my skills may be inadequate to assess it.
Explain.
Imagine the Terrans obtained one of our fabrication matrices. Could their scientists ever understand its engineering? The task set before me is of a similar scale. The Zelnaga were beings beyond our understanding.
Keep working, Carrick. I have faith in you.
Sorry if one of my cords was bumping against the mic. Alright, so what are we looking at here? Allows the Nexus to automatically attack nearby enemy units for 20 damage. Okay, the overcharge. We've unlocked a whole new column. Orbital Assimilator, Sphere of Adun, automatically harvest Vespine gas from assimilators without requiring probes. Okay, that's just a, you know, nice little one. Stargates and robotics facilities can transform to use like warp in. What? Okay. So we can make warp stargates and warp robotics facilities just like we have. That is awesome. Ooh, I didn't use the temporal field. So let's go with temporal field. Stargates and robo. I'm not really there for the. That's awesome, but I don't need it yet. Okay, that seems cool. Temporal field, pylon. Let's bump the pylon up. And we'll go with lesser construction time. Now, the starting supply, I mean, mostly you don't need that. If you're used to multiplayer, of course, you can always build pylons and then you won't get blocked up. But it does cost you a lot of resources to do that in the beginning that could be spent on, say, zealots. So, yeah, this looks good. And
the evacuation ships have reported in.
All right, let's do it. What's this? Destroy Xena stones first 10 minutes. Hold out for 1.8.
Tell me, Vorazun, how do you bring destruction to your world?
The Zelnaga Temple's phase prism can be overloaded, forcing a spike of energy into the planet's core. Enough of a charge, and the planet will shatter. Amon will not possess my world.
I've been thinking about this choice.
Are you reconsidering?
No. My time here has reminded me of the courage of your people. That we must fight. If we are to suffer, then so too will Amon. We will lure as many of Amon's hybrid and zerg.
She's totally into this revenge talk.
Only once enough are through to wound him will we overload the temple and flee.
You mean to bleed him? Bald, but we can't risk the forces it would require to do such a thing.
Leave that to me, Matriarch. I have learned much from the Dark Templar.
Like how to bleed. Ha ha ha. Oh, just too soon? Too soon. Alright, we're going to try and be a little faster on the macro this time. I'm not going to say I'm totally warmed up, but I think I felt sloppy last time, and I got it this time. Okay, got to remember my Dark Templar can die.
Our forces have secured the Zelnaga Temple grounds. Artex, how go your preparations?
I'm configuring the temple now. But without the Uruj and the Kallus, it will take time.
Uh-oh. Throwback.
Time is not all it
will. I hope there's a Starcraft rap band called Uruj and Kallus.
Can the temple be overloaded?
Until then, we must defend it from the Zerg and their hybrid masters.
The Nerazim have long used Kaderan monoliths to protect our lands. I see your face, Smith, has become familiar with them.
Indeed, Matriarch. The monoliths are quite deadly and fire a considerable distance. They should prove instrumental in our defense.
The moment has come.
Okay.
Let us begin.
Okay. Defenses, offenses. Okay, upgrade that. Upgrade that.
The sooner the Zenith stones are destroyed, the better off we shall be. The Zerg will overwhelm the temple grounds shortly.
Agreed. Although, should it become necessary, my Dark Templar can sneak through the enemy and destroy the stones.
Okay, destroy the stones in the first 3 minutes is a thing. Let's just send those guys off, see how that goes. It's much easier to gather minerals than it is to gather gas.
Exercise caution when attacking a zenith stone. The energies within may become volatile as it is damaged.
Oh, what does that mean? Well, I guess if my dudes die, they'll come back, right? Okay, we want to keep things coming. We do have another base available over here, so...
The Zerg gather for an attack to the southwest. Ignite your blade, warriors.
Okay, we want to build up to build another nexus, if only... Let's see. If only so that we can... build more things faster. Okay, our... Yeah, that wasn't a problem. Oh.
Hierarch, there are more resources nearby. We can construct a second nexus near them to accelerate our harvesting.
Okay, I was a little late, guys. I apologize. Okay, looks like there's baddies coming from there too. Baddies coming from all over. Gonna need more warp.
Another brood of zerg is preparing to attack from a hive to the northwest.
All right, Dark Shrine coming in. Things are not hard to kill. Let's get this one overloaded first. Kill it.
If possible, we should warp in more photon cannons. They will help our nexus point defend against enemy incursions.
These things cost a lot. Okay, slaughter them, my minions. Oh, I already have a probe on permanent duty.
temple grounds are still vulnerable. We should construct more photon cannons and Kaderan monoliths before they are overrun.
Get our shield leveled up. What? Let's go kill those things before anything else shows up. I should have built. I can just activate it. I can do three of these. Oh, it's got a chance to miss. All right, let's get more stalkers on the field.
Only some of your gateways have transformed into warp gates. It is better to commit to a single warp in strategy.
Okay, upgrades. Oh no, I trapped myself where I didn't want to be. We did make a nice wall here. Enough.
Let them come. The Templar will endure.
Oh, here's gonna be a suicide strike. stay in my command queue and then die? They might not have actually died. Let's see, where do I want these things? Here. Where do my immortals go?
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
They're like, we're still hurting. Lose my little idle worker. Got my upgrades. Load the banelings. Avenger thing is up.
Hierarch, I have never borne witness to so many Zerg. Was this the threat my mother once faced?
No, Matriarch. This threat is a
no,
far
you're
greater
way more awesome.
And it will take all we have to resist it.
Those were the right choice. Okay. Let's chill out those guys. One of those. And I killed my minimap. I don't know. This queen here is looking pretty devious. Maybe that guy. Oh, we missed. You can miss. Oh, we got... things built near all my beautiful.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Okay, flying things, not so bad. Got one. Okay, of course, as they build creep towards us. Does get faster. Give them faster movement, that is.
Temple.
Oh, you would.
Longer, I should be able to retrieve it. Begin the retrieval process, Kerax. We will hold the temple as long as we can.
Let's just take a moment to inspect what's going on. Okay, we just need to hold up here. Wasn't the button. Well, this does have a nice little pause function. It's interesting how my screen is restricted. Is this like... Okay, let's freeze that one. I'm gonna drop a trap here. So I want to see if that actually freezes things or not. Drop one here. Okay. I'm just gonna go with the kind of hectic defense in depth thing. Drums, does it?
Solarite retrieval is still in progress. If we can hold on just a while longer.
The hotkey for this? Do these not have hotkeys? Okay, let's see if we can catch two of those, at least one. those. Just aim for one of those. Okay. Things. Oh yeah, 1.7. Sprinkle a couple of Templar around. Your face is under attack. Probably good to cut these things in half. Oh, we're at max. Keep throwing down. .469 temple. Done. Oh, nice. So I got really into this one. It went like 15 minutes over. Poise these nuts in your mouth, Zerg. We'll be right back. Yeah, I just couldn't have stopped in the middle of that mission and come back to it. Got me all amped up. Oh, that is gross and awesome. That's kind of dumb looking, but I like it.
It is said that those of our kind suffer, separated from the glory of the Kala.
Yes, shields are the best. It's like X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. Oh, shields are down. Shields are down. Hit points dropping quickly. Dogpile.
But none of us are ever truly alone. For our warrior hearts are bound.
What is happening?
Tradition. Battle is waged in the name of the many. The brave, whose generation after generation choose the mantle of Dark Templar.
Oh snap, did Artanis just go dark? That was so awesome. Oh, that was fantastic. That was fantastic. Oh, we missed one. Oh, we're supposed to hold out to 1.8, maybe? We did get a bonus objective. It was 1.8 billion Zerg. I just looked up at that mini. Well, whatever. Close. We could have done it. Everyone knows we could have. I mean, obviously, Artanis only got out there like 1 second before the shockwave destroyed the entire planet. But that was enough. So we didn't miss anything practical. Maybe on my brutal playthrough, we'll hold out to 1.8 billion Zerg, and then we'll laugh and cry again, just like we did at the end of this one. So thank you so much for watching. I know I went over time, but it was totally worth it. That was a mission that really didn't let up, and I was really feeling it. So, yeah, that's it. I think this mission in particular, you really need to at least have two hotkeys. I had two, one for my Dark Templar and one for, and I think the Avenger really helped out there, as I could pay less attention to keeping them alive. Obviously, if you're a skilled StarCraft player, you can do a little bit better, more damage with the Nerazim version. Stalkers, definitely worth bringing on this one. I can't imagine the Dragoons being all that good, and I think my choice of the standard Immortal was the right one. One thing I might do when I play through again is focus on getting more photon cannons up early. I would probably have, if I could help it, two different stalker groups and maybe two different Dark Templar groups if my fingers were feeling a little bit faster. And I would probably try and remember to use my ship abilities more. I really like the pause was actually really nice. Just in selecting your targets with those, it gives you a nice like breather on the incredible intensity of the mission. And whenever you use them, I think it's best to stasis half the units, or like maybe the more deadly unit or the least deadly units. So as you cut each attack in half, you can still kill half of the attack before the stasis wears off, letting you like thin their numbers to feet in detail. All right, so that's it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. And until next time, do as I say, not as I do.